Oblivion is an absolute fan favorite in the Elder Scrolls series. Now, I'm a Morrowind man myself because I am just that old, but what if you could actually take Oblivion with you on the go and also mod it on your Steam Deck? Today, we're going to show you how. And the first thing we're going to do is jump into desktop mode. Now, if you don't know how to get to the actual desktop of your Steam Deck, don't freak out. Hit the Steam button in the front of your Steam Deck, go down to the power section, click that, and then move down to switch to desktop mode. That'll take you right here. Now, once you're here, you're gonna go over to the left-hand side, hit the little bag over here, and this will take you to the actual Discovery Store. You wanna look for a specific flat pack, and that is actually called Proton Tricks. Now, if I could spell, that would be fantastic. I'm just going to type Proton in here. Now, I already have Proton Tricks installed. As you can see, it's right here. Go ahead and click install it, and you don't have to launch it. So don't freak out if you haven't run or anything else like that. It just needs to be in the actual deck for MO2 to actually run. We're going to get to that in a second as well. Now, once you've installed Proton Tricks, you're going to want to install another flat pack as well. This one is called Flat Seal. Now you're thinking to yourself, like, these are really weird names. What's going on? Well, these are just going to be the things we need to actually get everything running on the back end. Now, Flat Seal is still active in the actual store. Once you've installed it, you want to run this actual flat pack. And we're going to just have this open right here. Now, I'm just going to maximize that for you. On the left-hand side, scroll down. You're going to see Proton Tricks. Click that. And then in the main menu, I'm just going to move myself real quick, by the way. Don't freak out. Boom, there it is. You're going to want to scroll down here. And what you want to make sure to do is where it says allow, you have all of these ticked. So it's going to say controller area network, application shared memory, programs from other architectures, development cycles, and etc. You want these main ones all ticked. And you want also the file system ones ticked as well. It's really important because it's going to allow Proton Tricks to have access to a lot of stuff in Linux. Now I'm going to put myself back on the other side this way, and we're going to go ahead and download what's called Mod Organizer 2, which is a main Linux version. Now what you want to do is go ahead and open up your favorite browser. We're using Firefox because that's what came with the actual Steam Deck, and I'm very lazy. I don't want to use another browser. So you can actually use the link that I put in the description. You're thinking to yourself, how am I going to get to the video and click the link? Well, you can just watch the YouTube video on your Steam Deck. It's a computer, by the way. It's pretty neat that you can do this. Now, once you are on the GitHub page for Mod Organizer 2, scroll down a little bit, and just above my head, you're gonna see 4.3.2 latest 5 days ago updated. Click that. That's gonna take you to the downloads page. When you scroll down a little bit as well, you're gonna see MO2 installer 4.3.2.tar.gz. Click that, you're gonna automatically download it as well. We're gonna show you how to get to that in just a moment. But before we do, I wanna make this very clear. You can in fact install your games inside of the Steam Deck while you have it in desktop mode. And this is really important. Do not, under any circumstances, install Oblivion onto an SD card. Mod Organizer 2 will not function if the game is not installed on the main SSD or the NAND memory of the actual Steam Deck. Do not install it onto the SD card. Do not. I'm going to repeat it. Do not install the game onto the SD card. We've seen it happen so many times already. People in the comment section, I followed this to the letter and it didn't work. Your video was bad because I installed it on my SD card. Well, there's your sign. But if you already have it on your SD card and you want to actually move it over to your SSD, it's not a big issue. In the game files, go ahead and click the gear icon over here, click properties. And what you're going to want to do is go over where it says installed files, and you can move the installed folder. Now, since my game is already installed onto the SSD, the only option is for the micro SD card. So I'm going to click cancel. You will see the opposite of this. You will see move it over to your SSD or your NAND memory or whatever you want to call it and on that side. And once you move the install files there, you'll be fine and good to go. Now, if anything does occur where it starts acting up, I would just uninstall the game and then do a clean install back onto the main drive of your Steam Deck, and it should work after that. So I just want to make that very clear so that way there's no issues and you guys can actually enjoy all the mods you want to place in Oblivion. Now, once you've got MO2 downloaded and you've got Oblivion installed correctly, let's go ahead and jump into Nexus Mods. Now, here's the mod that I'm going to be using. It's called Alternate Start Arrive by a Ship. I just want to do something really quick and simple so you guys can see how it works. Now, depending on the mods, you want to make sure that you read all the dependencies that the mod requires. You have to make sure you're getting the right ones with the right dependencies and adding them correctly so that way you have no issues. Of course, that is going to be dependent upon which mod you want to do. Because we're not using the Nexus Mod Manager, go ahead and click Manual Download and you will download a zip file. Do not open the zip file. You want to keep it as is, and it's going to be in the same folder of downloads that we saw MO2 with as well. So now that we've got all that done, let's begin. Now, with all of that out of the way, let's go ahead and get these installs taken care of. Down on the bottom left-hand side, you see a file, which is the Dolphin File Manager. Go ahead and open that. Now, mine automatically opens to downloads because I was already there, but make sure you're in the downloads folder. You're going to see MO2 installer.4.3.2, or .2, excuse me. Take all the files that you see here, highlight them, click and drag them into your downloads folder. What you want to do next is double-click install.sh. So we'll go ahead and we'll do that now. We're going to see a little bit of a pop-up here. And we're going to see Endero Forgotten Stories, Fallout 3, Fallout 4, New Vegas, New Vegas RU, Morrowind, and Oblivion. We're going to select Oblivion and click OK. Now it's going to say a couple of things before we get started. Make sure the game has no launch options set. It's really important that you do that. We'll go over this in just a moment. And make sure the game is configured to use Proton 8.0. Now, if you haven't updated your Steam Deck, make sure you do, because Proton 8.0 came with an update recently. So let's just do this. Let's just go ahead and get these things taken care of so we can make sure that everything is nice and easy. Go back into Steam, go into Oblivion, go to the gear icon on the right-hand side again. Click Properties. Now, if you want to make sure if you have no launch options, scroll down and you can see launch options right here under the General tab. It's empty. That's all you want to see. Nice and easy. Go to compatibility, because I can't say that word. You want to click force a specific use of the play compatibility tool. I can't even read today. A Steam Play compatibility tool. Now mine says 8.0-3 because I unchecked it and rechecked it. That's the one you want to use. If for some reason you cannot check this box over here, simply restart Steam. And when I say restart Steam, don't restart your Steam Deck. Treat it like a PC. You can just simply just close Steam and you'll be fine. So you can just go over the top left over here, Steam, exit, boom, you close Steam, but you're still in the Steam Deck in the Steam UI with the Steam OS. Yeah, I know it sounds confusing, but think of it as just like using your regular desktop PC. That's all it is. So again, if you can't select it, just restart the Steam application. Don't restart your Steam Deck. That's unnecessary. And now with all of that done, you've got everything set. Let's go back to MO2. We're going to go ahead here and say all done. Let's continue. And we're going to click OK. Now we're going to install it exactly where it is. We're not going to change it. We're going to keep it the same place because we don't want to mess with anything. And it has to be exactly where it is. So it's going to say the directory does not exist. Do you want to create it? Yes, I do. It's going to go ahead and download everything, put everything together. And then we're going to go ahead and test Mod Organizer 2. Once it's all done, you're going to see this pop-up where it says installation was successful. Launch the game on Steam to use Mod Organizer 2. If for whatever reason you don't get this pop-up, then either A, you change the directory where it's being installed, or you just make sure you reinstall the actual program again by double-clicking install.sh. If that still doesn't work, then you restart your Steam Deck and then double-click it again, and it should work then. Now, with all of that taken care of, we've got MO2 installed. We've got an actual mod we want to use. Let's go ahead and launch Mod Organizer 2. We're just going to click play on Oblivion Game of the Year Edition and see what happens. You should get a really weird pop-up that's sort of like green and showing everything. So hopefully we did this right, because if it's not, that'd be kind of embarrassing. And as you can see, I did a little quick cut, but here's the window that I was talking about where it popped up. And now we can make a new instance with Mod Organizer 2. We're going to go ahead and say yes is an instance full of set of mods, downloads, and profiles. Click next. We're going to create a global instance to keep it all the same. We're going to go ahead and select the game to manage, which is going to be Oblivion. We're going to go ahead and say next on this as well. And then we're going to say create a new instance. Yes, we're going to click next. Now you can go ahead and connect to Nexus Mod Manager here directly. But me, I don't like doing that. I'm an old-fashioned kind of guy. I'm the kind of guy who used to actually install add-ons to WoW just in the interface folder manually. That's what I like to do. If you want to connect to Nexus, you can. Just make sure you have your login information that'll walk you through this process. It's very simple to do as well. But for me, I'm a manual kind of guy, so I'm going to do it myself and click next. Now we're going to go ahead and do all this stuff for the new instance and click finish. And it's going to finish everything up here. Get a nice mod organizer 2 pop up. We're using it for the first time. Yes, we're going to do a tutorial, so we'll make it nice and simple for you guys, even though we've done this multiple times already. It's not a big deal. So as you can see, mod organizer 2 is not set up to handle NXM links associated with NXM links. That means Nexus Mod Manager links that you can click on to download automatically. I'm going to say no and don't ask again. It's not a big deal for me. Now, if you want to do that for yourself, you actually can. So down at the bottom, welcome to Mod Organizer 2 tutorial. It's pretty simple, nothing too bad. It'll walk you through each little thing. You see a little gray box over here? That's what I'm talking about. I know I'm in the way. Yeah, you'll be all right. You can read it. It's okay. So we're going to do all the highlighted buttons, all that good stuff, multiple sources of information, all that great stuff here in the top right for this actual help section. If you want to do that, there's tooltips everywhere. Now, this does look a little bit more complicated than it does with, let's say, Nexus Mod Manager, but you really won't have an issue with any of that. What this is doing is just walking you through the actual setup process and just giving you a guidance on what you want to do. I've done this before. So for here, definitely read all the little gray boxes. Take your time, go through everything. That way you understand what is actually happening in Mod Organizer 2. But it's honestly pretty easy to work through. It's not really that bad. So again, it's saying you can use your regular browser to download from Nexus. Please open the Nexus tab right over here. Click this button to download to the Download with Manager if you want to do that too. So again, you can do all of these things if you want to connect to Nexus and do all that kind of stuff. It's absolutely available for you as well. So this is the part where things get a little bit more confusing, so I'm going to go a little bit slower here. You see where it's actually being highlighted in green around this box? This is where all the actual mods that are downloaded are and plugins that you actually have needed to be active and turned on. Now, if you want to go ahead and activate all of these, just left-click inside the box and then right-click Enable All. This will actually enable all of the actual mods that you have listed here, which is really nice to see. Again, you also have your downloads here as well if you want to do that too, and anything else along that line as well. So the first thing we did was enable all of these really great plugins for all the DLC so that they're active and ready to go. So now that we've got all the DLC active, let's go ahead and install the alternate start for Oblivion. So what you want to do is, for me, like I said, I'm a manual kind of person. We're going to go back to our Dolphin file browser and we're going to see our alternate start zip file. We're not going to open it. We're just going to click it and drag it over here and up in this area where all the mods are. Do not go down here. It's not going to let you install it in this way. So up here, click and drag, and you're going to drop it in. And then when you minimize the actual window for the Dolphin file browser, you're going to see quick install, alternate start. You're going to click OK. It's going to install that here. And then now, boom, it says, great, you installed your first mod. Please note the installation procedure may differ based on how a mod was packaged. So again, making sure that you actually understand and read all the mods that were actually set up and what the dependencies actually are for each mod. So like I said before, what you want to make sure to do is that you have your mod enabled. And to do that really quickly, just again, just left click it here. You can click enable selected and it will actually activate on the right hand side. Now, depending on the mod, you want to make sure the mod order is loaded correctly. For alternate start, I had to click and drag it above all of the other DLC. So to do that, it's really easy. You can just right click it and hold it all the way up here and then drag it right above everybody else. And you won't have to really worry to make sure that everything is loaded. If everything seems fine, you can go back into game mode and run this. It'll open up Mod Organizer 2 again. Use your touch screen to click run and you'll be fine. Or if you want to play in desktop mode, not a big deal. Go ahead and just click run. And if everything is good, we should actually launch into Oblivion. And then from here, we should in fact be able to just go ahead and have our alternate start on that boat. So let's see if I did it right. and let's see if we're actually on the right path, because hopefully we are. If not, that would be incredibly embarrassing now, wouldn't it? So we're loading it up here. Bethesda Studios, fantastic. Yes, Elder Scrolls, all that good stuff. Let's go ahead and click new. Start a new game. And we should be on a boat. We are on a boat. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and open up our character name. Click done. And we're going to say yes, because I don't really care. We're just going to do this as a test. And here we are on a boat. We are now with a brand new quest. We're not in the jail anymore. We are discovering a note from Bothiel at the Arcane University, if I can recover the Dwarven artifacts. So as you can see, this is not the typical start that you would get from playing Morrowind normally. This is an alternate start if you want to go ahead and do that, which is honestly really cool. So it's just nice to see and do all that here. So there you go. Your mods are all set if you'd like to do that. I'm going to go ahead and start doing some wild, wacky stuff here. You can move some controls as well with the Steam Deck, but you can customize that on your own, and you're all done. Mod Organizer 2 can be a little bit funny to get work with in the beginning, but once you follow the tutorial, you should be fine. It really won't be that much of an issue, and you can connect your Nexus account to it to make downloading mods even simpler. But that's pretty much it. If you guys want to see more of this kind of content, subscribe. We're getting close to 50,000 subs, and it really does mean a lot. So we are doing more PC port reviews, gaming news, Steam Deck videos, fanboy content, as well as live streams every Saturday. So if you want to support the channel, again, subscribe. So thank you guys again as well. Now, if you want access to the Discord and also emotes for the channel, you can consider becoming a YouTube member. I've lowered it as much as possible to $1. And if you don't want to give $1, that's perfectly cool. I just want to say thank you for watching all the way to the end, because that means more to me than anything. But anyways, y'all, thank you so much for watching. Hope you have a great one, and I'll see you next time.